How to get rid of gout. This is one of the most searched topics regarding gout on YouTube. And you may have opened this video hoping to find a cure for gout. But the truth is, there is no cure. I want to be straightforward so you can avoid the emotional roller coaster of trying to find a cure. Having your hopes up just for it to drop. The emotional and financial burden are significant. Many people are taken advantage of because they're so desperate at finding a cure, making them susceptible to marketing strategies and believing in this miraculous cure. I want you to be informed. Despite the absence of cure, gout is a condition that can be well managed with medication and self-management strategies. When we say manage, it means putting the condition into remission and reducing the frequency and intensity of the flare-ups. And we will use the latest evidence supported by the American College of Rheumatology to help you better manage your gout. Gout is a type of inflammatory condition caused by hyperuricemia, a high level of uric acid. Supersaturation of uric acid could cause the formation of monosodium urate, a sharp crystal which could get deposited into the joint. And when this happens, it will trigger an inflammatory process, making the joint red, hot, swollen, and painful. If your gout is not properly managed, your uric acid level could become chronically high, promoting the development of irreversible joint damage, formation of kidney stones and tophi, accumulation of crystals in your joint. They appear as hard nodules under the skin. Historically, gout is thought to be a condition of the rich caused by excess. A successive consumption of alcohol, meat, and seafood could cause hyperuricemia. This assumption has led to a stigmatization that diet was the underlying problem causing gout. But in reality, there is an important genetic contribution to the development and severity of gout. Diet is important, but it's more important to reduce stigmatization, patient blaming, and recognize genetics as a strong contributing factor to the development of gout. The underlying problem for gout is hyperuricemia, excessive production of uric acid. The sensible solution to manage gout would be lowering the body's production and your overall intake of uric acid. And we can achieve this by modifying our diet, staying hydrated, and avoid excessive consumption of alcohol or any products that contains high fructose corn syrup, such as soft drinks and the popular brand of cookie that is taken with milk. We also want to limit puring by reducing consumption of red meat, organ meat, and seafood. Exercise and weight loss is also important. A study has found individuals who have lost more than 5% of their baseline body mass index had a 40% decreased risk of recurrent gout attack. This finding is significant and highlights the importance of weight loss in reducing the frequency of your gout attack. Physical activity is safe, provided you follow the principles of optimal loading. By the end of the year, we will release a self-management program designed for individuals with gout. This program will not cure your gout, but it will be effective at reducing the frequency and intensity of your gout attack. For medication, it is strongly recommended to initiate urine-lowering therapy for individuals with tophi, radiographic damage, or more than 2 flare-ups a year. To optimize patient outcome, it is recommended to maintain a serum urine target of less than 6 mg per deciliter. Allopurinol is a preferred first-line therapy. If you're Southeast Asian or African-American, you need to understand you have an elevated risk for allopurinol hypersensitivity syndrome. For this population, it's recommended to do a genotype testing for HLA-B5801 prior to starting allopurinol. Gout is an inflammatory condition. It can be effectively managed with urine-lowering therapy and self-management strategies. To help us build a healthier community, please leave a comment on some of the triggers for your gout attack. Thank you for watching.